Hey friends, Zen Kuna here, and using a lightweight club today. This is just a little bit under a pound actually, because I'm going to demonstrate for you the different grips that I use. Now a lot of people don't pay that much attention to their grip. They're sort of here, there, it's a little questionable to me. The way I like to teach it is give you numbers. So let's start with the grip. Now, some people are going to tell you always got to have your little finger down on the knob. I don't train that way. I might be here, I might be there, depending on the weight. If it's a little too heavy for me, I might choke up on a club. Lots of possibilities of where I'm going to hold it. But let's take a look at the basic position. So, if the club is like so, I call this the two position. So this is going to be number two, whether or not it's here, or there, or if I'm turned over here, or if I'm out to the side, if I'm overhead, that's always going to be a two. So then, here's two, this is one. So you notice with one that this club is in line with my arm. Let me show you what isn't one. You'll see this a lot with people. This is not one, nor do you want to try and get to one by over stretching the wrist, which puts a lot more pressure up here. What you want to do is let that club slide through your fingers a little bit until the knob is in line with your arm. So let's just review that again. We'll take a look at one and two. One position, two position. Now, everybody knows there's the old one, two, three. There's three. So three is lying down on top of my arm. It would be a three position if it was here, if it was here, if it was up here. This would always be a three position, just like this would be a two, and this would be a one. So, now let's refine a little bit. Here's our one position. We can also do a reverse two. So instead of the muzzle being up in the direction where my thumb is, it's down towards my little finger. So that's a reverse two. If I put my thumb on here and bend it up, I've got a reverse three. All right? So, reverse two, I bring this back up, I've got my reverse, or I've got my regular one, two, and three. Now, obviously, you could be anywhere in between one and two, two and three. I have numbers for that too, don't worry about it. Here we go. Here's one. Now we could do a 1.25, or we could do a 1.5, take us up to our two. We could go into a 2.25, 2.50, 2.75, hey! And all the way down to a three. You might not think that it's too significant knowing that, but the way I teach clubs, we do a lot of digital dexterity. And I find it has helped my students tremendously to understand the different positions. Let's review them again then. So starting from one. One, 1.25, 1.50, 1.75, two. 2.25, 2.50, 2.75, three. All right, reversed that, and we would have our two and reversed three. There are times when you use those. All right. Now, let's take one more consideration of all of this. When you're first training, it's best to actually go through these numbers just the numbers. In other words, not trying to do it while swinging. So, let's take them out to the side, for example. And we'll just go through our positions. Then you do the same thing with them right down by your side. So here I'm in a one, here I'm in a two. Now I'm going to give it a little bit of a flip to come up into three, and there's my three position. So you can see also that depending on the length of your club, it's going to make a difference of where the club reaches. Thank you. however you do it, the number is always the same. In other words, wherever my arms are. So if I was directly overhead in a one position, and then I went into a two, or I rotated my arms this way or that way, it wouldn't make any difference. This would still be a two, a one, a three. All right. So I think I've beaten that dead horse enough. You've got the basic idea of the one, two, three of club grip, and we'll go into more detail about that in another video. So stay tuned. Adios.